two, one, two, three, four. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Welcome to the channel. We hope you enjoy your visit. But remember, while you are here, beware of the pits.
Here's a little bicycle wrench from Morgan and Wright Company. A couple of things that really attracted me to this wrench were, number one, it was a wrench that was put out by a bicycle company. Morgan and Wrench Company was started in 1891 and operated till about 1906 or 1909. It was bought by Uniroyal Company. But during that time, they made every type of bicycle part and repair, paints, tools possible to maintain and keep your bicycle in order. Also, they were the world's largest manufacturer of bicycle tires during that time. So not only did they have the tires, they had the whole shebang. Another thing that attracted me to this wrench was it said patented March 25th, 1935. That's really 1835. Excuse me. 1835 would make this 186 years old. So I thought, I don't have any wrenches that old. What an early patent date. But I got to looking closer because that type of design came along later. In fact, I've got quite a few wrenches that very similar in design. In fact, these two here on either side, very, very similar. Here's another bicycle wrench and another design here. All of them pretty similar with the same type adjustment knob on here. But the ones the closest would be these. And this one that I had restored earlier, which is a Barnes Tool Company. Heck, they could have even made this wrench for them. I'm not too sure what, because they're so very similar. So I went out to the world and started looking, the world being the internet, trying to find the patent on this item. And really, since the company was started in 1891, but they put out a wrench with their name on it, Morgan and Wright, patented in 1835. So I'm just, you know, nothing was matching. But I did find something from 1835 I'll show you now. Here's what I found. The first wrench ever patented, at least in the U.S., was patented by Solomon Merrick of Springfield, Massachusetts, on August 17th, 1835. That year matches the date of the wrench I have, the bicycle wrench, but nothing like it. Completely different. I don't know what they did unless they used that patent date on there, because it was a wrench. I don't know. There's no relation to it. I don't really believe that little bicycle wrench was manufactured and patented in 1835. Just doesn't seem right. Anyway, did find the first wrench ever patented. I thought you'd be interested in seeing. Now it's time to get a little closer look at this wrench and make some decisions about what to do. First of all, it's got a name or initials marked on here. Looks like it was done with a little punch and letters were spelled out. Maybe H-E-D or H-E-O, not sure what it is. And, you know, there's some staining and some pitting and corrosion on here. But for the age, if it's in fact 1890, in the 1890s, it puts it around 130 years old. If it's the date they say on here, it's 180-something. But either way, I don't know. There were a lot of bicycle wrenches out. I don't think there's a lot of historical value on here because that early date, I don't know why it's on here, but it doesn't seem right. I'm not going to go crazy on this wrench, but I am going to wire brush it and see what we have from there to decide if we need to stick with that finish, which is more the natural finish on here, or go ahead and give it a good shine to, again, I'm not too sure of the historical value here on this wrench. But after I do the wire brushing, we'll decide from there. Okay, here's a little look-see at this tool after a lot of wire brushing. The problem is there's just a lot of staining on here. And so, you know, some tarnishing, pitting, some banging on it, but just not going to get it cleaned up enough. I think I want to get it a little better looking than this. Don't think there's any great historical value here. Yeah, interesting is that 1825 name or 1835, whatever it was, name on the 1835 on the patent date, which I don't think is realistic. Doesn't seem right to me. But I do want to clean up this little wrench. And you can see what's on here. It's just not going to come out with wire brushing, especially where they mark the name on here. So I'm going to go ahead and get a little more aggressive with it and get it cleaned up and nicer looking. Try to take those initials out of it here, which I don't want in there. Thought maybe I could do it with wire brushing to make it look more authentic, but just can't do it. So I'll get out my belt sander and see what I can do. Well, here we are back at the beginning, what this wrench looked like when I got it. I struggled a little bit trying to get a correct finish on here. I just couldn't seem to get the right thing. First, I did it in a real bright, shiny, really mirror-like finish, and it just wasn't right. I didn't take a picture of it even. I just went ahead and did other things to it. I should have shown you what it looked like, but sometimes things just don't look right, and that one didn't look right. So here's what we did to finish the wrench. Basically, put a brush-type finish on it, which I think looked a little better. And you can see it's sort of a brushed finish on here. The area where the name is and the area with that weird patent date. I didn't do completely because I didn't want to remove that information. That's the historical information on this wrench. But we put a little black stain in this little indent area here just to give it a little contrast. And, of course, this side was where that name was cut on there, was put on there, and I got that off by sanding. And there was a lot of rough spots on here. Got them taken care of and smoothed out, but I kind of like the brushed finish on here. Looks good without being too over the top, which that shiny one was. It just wasn't coming out right on here, so that's what I did. And to get that finish, I tried to wire brush on it over and over, and I tried a coarse and a medium wire brushing and couldn't quite get it right. And sanding, of course, took it back to the shiny again. So I've had these for a while, and I've talked about using what they call, it's a red label, but they call it a surface conditioner, non-woven. I got this information from Magdad. Thank him for that, because it's really a well-used piece in my shop. And this abrasive comes in different grades. the red being very coarse. And then there was a brown, which was a medium. And then there was a blue, which is a real fine, which I've got on the belt sander now. But that blue gives it really the same type finish that the fiber wheel does. It gives it a nice, beautiful finish like the fiber wheel. So I would use these in place of that fiber wheel. So in this case, I used the red, which was the coarse. And the coarse is what gave it this brush type appearance on here. So sometimes you just got to experiment. Thanks to Magdad for giving me that tip on this red level of red label abrasives. They're not cheap. The three belts are like $25, and they don't work on all the different belt sanders. I'm finding the old Harbor Freight one I had, which was at the end of life anyway. I replaced it with a nice wind unit, which I like very well. But it never could get that to work quite right on my Harbor Freight one. And they're difficult to get on when they're new. But once you get them on and get them working, they do a nice job. So now I'm able to do a brush finish and just a medium, which if I don't want a particularly highest shine, and then I go with the blue for the highest shine finish. So something you may want to try. It sure is a product I use a lot. In fact, I ordered a second set because I had just worn out my first one and over about a period of about 6 months. So there's what I did for the Morgan and Wright wrench that supposedly was patented in 1835 with that date. I guess you can't believe everything you say, even if it's set in steel on the wrench, because I just don't believe that this was patented in 1835. I don't know why that date's on there. Can't find out why. But it did turn out nice. Nice little bicycle wrench. Pleased to have it. Thanks for watching the video.